What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to install and play the Industrial Foregoing mod in Minecraft. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. As you get familiar with vanilla Minecraft gameplay, you get to know ways to progress and tasks to complete to get farther along in the game. Whether it's making mob farms, mining, or growing food, these tasks are pretty simple really, but they can get repetitive. A lot of players find it kind of tedious that they still have to grow food even after achieving netherite armor, especially after playing for so long. This is where Industrial Foregoing comes in. With this mod, you can create and automate machines to collect resources and much more. Let's go over how to install it and how to play. Visit the Industrial Foregoing download page and press the Files button at the top of the page to view all of the downloads. Find the version that you want to use and then press the download button to the right-hand side. And after that finishes, save the file to a safe location like a separate folder because we will need it again in just a minute. You'll want to do the exact same thing with the matching version of the titanium dependency. Head to your Apex panel page and stop the server. Scroll down to the game file section and make sure the server is running a matching version of Minecraft Forge to the mod that you downloaded. Afterwards, head to FTP file access in the left-hand menu, log in, and find or create the mods folder, and then enter it. Press the upload button in the top left, and on the next page, drag and drop the mod files. Once it has 100% uploaded, click on your username at the top of the page, which will send you back to the main panel page where you can restart the server. To install the mod client side, first make sure Forge is downloaded, which we have a guide to if you need to know how to do that. After that, open your Minecraft launcher and then head to Installations at the top. Hover over your profile and then press the Open Folder icon to the far right. Find or create the Mods folder, enter it, and then you can paste the two mod files into this section. Now you can return to the Minecraft launcher and press play. Once you spawn into your world, the first task is going to be creating plastic in order to make the dissolution chamber. To do this though, you're going to need a few things, starting with a pity machine frame. This is used in most starter recipes for creating plastic. With your pity machine frame crafted, you can now create fluid extractors. These blocks will slowly extract latex from an attached tree. While you technically only need one, you can make four for each side of the log to speed up the process. You can right-click any extractor to view its progress and how much latex has been stored. You will need a full tank to receive a bucket of latex for the next recipe. With your new bucket of latex, you can create the next required block, the latex processing unit. This block combines power, latex, and water in order to make tiny dry rubber. Once you have a fair bit of that tiny dry rubber, you are finally ready to create plastic. Simply combine 9 of the tiny dry rubber in a crafting table, which will provide you with dry rubber. Afterwards, toss that into a furnace to cook and you will finally have plastic. Before we move on to the next step, this is a great chance to start automating the creation of plastic. In order to do this though, you are going to need to install the mod mechanism since we're going to be using items that are found in that mod. First, create a water condensator with the following recipe. To make an iron gear, you're going to need to place 4 iron ingots into a crafting table in a circle shape across the top, bottom, left, and right. Place your new water condenser next to some water source blocks and it will begin accumulating water automatically. Like the extractors, it will work without power, but it will generate faster if energy is added. Now, using the fluid pipes from the mod mechanism, you can connect the latex extractors and water condenser into the latex processing unit. Once that's set up, the tiny dry rubber should generate without any additional intervention, creating plastic without you having to really do anything yourself. Once you have that plastic, you're finally ready to create the dissolution chamber, which is a crafting block used to create new frames, machine add-ons, tools, and so much more. To craft it, use this recipe. And to get the diamond gears, you're going to make it the same way as the iron gear, with 4 diamonds placed in a circle in a crafting table. If the game is giving you an error when starting up on either the server or the client, this is often caused by a missing mod dependency. Industrial Foregoing requires titanium to work, so make sure that the matching mod version is installed on both the client and the server. Once this is done, restart the server and your game, and then connect one more time. Industrial Foregoing definitely isn't one of your one-and-done mods, and it does take quite a bit of work to get it up and running. That being said, once you do have it working, it will make collecting resources for your gameplay so much easier, giving you more time to focus on progressing through your game in other ways. That's all for this one, gamers. As always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.